years after years after years, justice will prevail. It took 27 years with Nelson Mandela to get out and to be the president of his country. It took me only 14 years to prove to the world that I am the good person and they are the bad people.
Victoria Derbyshire talking to former Guantanamo detainee Shaker Aamer there. But not everyone is welcoming Mr. Aamer back to the UK. Earlier, I spoke to Hannah Stuart from the right-wing foreign affairs think tank, the Henry Jackson Society. I started by asking her if she thought Shaker Aamer was really a threat to the UK.
I'm not sure necessarily that Shaker Aamer poses now a threat to the United Kingdom, but certainly when he was picked up in Tora Bora, the allegations were that he was fighting on behalf of Osama bin Laden, whose house he's believed to have been at. He was working for Islamic charities, he says. They've later become designated as Al-Qaeda connected charities. So at the time, certainly the Americans believed that he was part of the Al-Qaeda network and was a threat not just perhaps to the UK, but to the wider Western world, who had just been attacked, as we remember, on 9/11.
He denies all of that, and he has said, prove it. Prove that I wasn't working for a charity that actually was a genuine charity. Prove that I was associated with Osama bin Laden and others who have turned out to be jihadi fighters. He says he was in Afghanistan in 2001 to do that charity work. And you, like the Americans, don't believe him.
I am perhaps not prepared to give him the benefit of the doubt that we've seen now mainstream commentators do. It seems that every allegation that's been put against him, because he has been a victim of human rights, and I'm not disputing that, It is now seen that everything that the Americans allege is untrue, but yet everything that he alleges the Americans did to him is true. And I think that's a double standard. And actually, both his behaviour and the Americans' behaviour should be under increased scrutiny.
I mean, what actual concrete evidence, other than claims and allegations from the US, is there that Shaker Aamer was a terrorist and an Al-Qaeda operative?
There's a number of bits of evidence, and a lot of those come from the WikiLeaks documents, which are the Guantanamo Bay interrogations and interviews where he has confessed to a number of actions, including training at Al-Qaeda-related
training
camps.
But he would have said that's under duress and as a result of torture.
The Americans have said that there have been a number of investigations into allegations of torture, and some of those they have said, yes, people were tortured, but not Shaker Aamer, and also not one of the other British detainees, Mozambique. The other thing is that men like, for example, Mozambique, have alleged at Guantanamo that Shaker was connected with Al-Qaeda operatives.
Although he says, again, that evidence was under duress, and we've heard, obviously, detailed claims by Shaker Aamer of extensive torture over, you know, a period of years.
And if those torture allegations are proven to be true, then that is a travesty and it's against his human rights, and it's actually lets down, I think, the Western world and what it's trying to do in its fight against jihadist groups. But the treatment meted out to him doesn't whitewash the allegations. And I think the interesting factor is that this is a man that chose to take his family to live under Taliban rule. I think that says a lot about the ideas and the sort of society that he would like to live in. And the charities that he was connected to are now, the charities he willingly acknowledges that he was working for, are now Al-Qaeda designated charities.
If the evidence is there, why is Shaker Aamer not currently facing trial?
Britain has no legal case against Shaker Aamer. They have no jurisdiction over his actions in Afghanistan at that time. We've seen with the British fighters joining the conflict in Syria an extension of jurisdiction in terms of joining prescribed organisations and training at terrorist training camps. That's something that's been put in place in the last 18 months. That wasn't there then. It's right that the legal system in the UK cannot be applied retrospectively. So we in this country do not have a legal case against Shaker Aamer.
Right, but the US has established a system of military tribunals, which is meant to address those issues, and some people from Guantanamo were actually tried in those military tribunals. So why wasn't that the case with Shaker Aamer?
I believe the military tribunals are very complex and difficult, and very few of the detainees have actually been put under military tribunal. Shaker Aamer was cleared a number of years ago, in 2007, I believe, for release to Saudi Arabia. That's what the Americans wanted to do for him, is release him back to his country of birth. He, however, chose to fight that. And some may say rightly or wrongly, because he wanted to be with his family in the UK, and then Britain fought for him to come back.
But ultimately, if there isn't enough evidence to convict somebody, how can there be enough evidence to detain someone without trial for so many years?
I don't think that there is a case. I don't think that Guantanamo should exist, and I don't think people should be held without trial. But that doesn't mean that I think that Shaker Aamer was innocent.